face to face, he said he respects you as a champion. So what do you think changed?
At the end of the day, if he doesn't respect me as a champion, why is he even fighting me then? Why are you forced to fight me? Why fight somebody that you feel isn't even a champion if you're just this big, bad, undisputed champion? He knows that I'm the WBC lightweight champion in the world, and he had to fight me.
Devin, you've always been confident in your skills, and I know you mentioned that to make this fight, you know, you just said whatever it takes to get it across. A lot of people are worried about the judges going down there in Australia. Do you think with the two fights being the rematch and the first fight that you could get a fair shake out there?
Yeah, it's fair judging. We did the proper things to make sure that it was going to be fair judging. So, yeah. That was our main focus. So now I just got to go in there, stick to my game plan, do what I do best, and come out on top. That's what I will do. We're not focused on the judges. The judges are going to do the right thing, and the best man going to win on that night.
And I asked your dad just recently about a hypothetical. Say you do come out victorious the first fight. You have all four belts. You're with top ranking ESPN on this partnership. Do you think it could be a step aside for Kambosos and you could actually fight Josh Taylor, undisputed versus undisputed?
I don't know. I can't say. I gotta focus on George Kambosos. I can't really look past him because this is Super Bowl of the lightweight division. This is for everything. How could I look past him when it's the highest achievement? And I didn't sign up for one. I signed up for two fights. So if he doesn't step aside, then I gotta honor that second fight. So, but it all starts with fight one. We can't look to fight two without winning fight one. So that's my main focus.
What would you say is the deepest division in boxing right now, lightweight or welterweight?
Lightweight, the best division in boxing. See, now they gonna start saying that the lightweight division is not the best boxing because there's one king. So it may not be the best division in boxing anymore because it's one guy that stands on the throne, and that's gonna be Devin Haney.
George Kambosos said that they gave you the same deal that they offered Lomachenko. Do you have any proof that your deal is the exact same deal that was offered to Loma?
I can't say if it was the same or nothing like that because there never was nothing in writing to compare or, you know what I'm saying? He never got that deep into it. So he can't say if it was the same deal or not. I can't say if it was the same deal or not. Maybe it was, maybe it wasn't. I don't know.
And Ryan recently came back. You and him have a great history when the amateurs. What's your thoughts about his layoff and coming back right to go?
Say it again, sorry about that.
I was saying Ryan recently came back after a long layoff. What was your reaction to him coming back and how did you think he looked?
I mean, he wasn't fighting nobody, so it's hard to really judge if he got better or if he got worse. He wasn't in there with a solid opponent. But I mean, he got the win. So yeah.
In the week before your fight, we got Tank and Haney, another lightweight. Tank and Rully.
I want that fight to happen one day.
Tank and Rully, man. What's your thoughts on that fight?
We all know Rully is not a solid fighter. He's not an elite fighter. We know that Tank is an elite fighter. So Tank gonna do what he gotta do. I feel like he gonna stop him early, probably like a body shot or something. Rully isn't nothing special.
Last question for me, you just sparred Shakur, you didn't spar Tank, you didn't spar Rolly. What do you rank those three in there?
They all good fighters, but I can't rank them. I don't remember enough. You know, it was different times, different periods. Some I was small, I was younger than others. Like one time I was this age, one time I was that age. They're all good fighters, and I knew that they were all gonna be at the top eventually. With me, I knew that we were all gonna one day have to meet up and crossroads.
Well, listen, man, I know you gotta go work out, so I got one more question for you, man. What was your reaction to Shakur Stevenson's performance over Oscar Valdez?
Shakur went there and he put on a good performance. He did everything I thought he would do, he showed his ring IQ. He showed his skill set was on a whole nother level, and congrats to him. I'm happy for him.
What do you want to leave for your boxing fans around the country and around the world, bro?
Thank you for all my fans that demanded this fight, that pushed for this fight. Thank you for all my supporters. And I look to come out on victorious. And you know, everybody that supported me, I look to prove you guys right and show the world that I'm the best fighter in the world.
Thanks, Dave.